Ja, herzlich willkommen an unsere Mitglieder des Windows Business Solution Club und natürlich auch diejenigen, die uns von außerhalb zuschauen. Wir sind hier auf der Microsoft Ignite in Orlando. Mein Name ist Manfred Helber, ich bin ein Microsoft Most Valuable Professional für das Thema Cloud and Data Center. Und neben mir steht Cosmos Darwin. Hello Cosmos, may you introduce yourself?
Yeah, hey Manfred, how are you? It's good to be here. My name is Cosmos Darwin. I'm a senior program manager on the CoreOS engineering team at Microsoft, specifically working on intelligent edge infrastructure for Azure.
Okay, perfect. And this is exactly the situation why we are here, because Azure Stack is, I feel, everywhere here, and we have several products that have Azure Stack in the name, the Azure Stack Edge, the Azure Stack Hub, the Azure Stack HCI, what's my focus topic. But I think it's very important to clarify what's maybe the difference between these products and what's the same, and I think it's easier to hand up the microphone to you so that you can use it to give us an answer about this topic.
Yeah, absolutely. So this week at Microsoft Ignite, we had lots of exciting news. One of the big pieces of news was that we've expanded Azure Stack from a single product into now a portfolio of products, as you said. So there are three products with the Azure Stack name. There's Azure Stack Edge, Azure Stack HCI, and Azure Stack Hub. So let's walk through a little bit where each of those came from and what they really are. So Azure Stack Hub is the product that was formerly known as simply Azure Stack. So if you know, if you have an idea in your head, oh, Azure Stack, that's Azure in my data center. That's a cloud-native integrated system that gives me essentially a full Azure region with a local instance of the Azure Resource Manager, a local instance of the Azure Portal, tenants, subscriptions, really Azure in my data center. If you know that product is now called Azure Stack Hub. Azure Stack HCI is the same foundational technologies as Azure Stack Hub, but available all packaged up and delivered through Windows Server in a way that's more familiar to an IT pro audience that maybe knows Hyper-V and knows Windows Server already and wants to use familiar tools and familiar processes to manage it. So that's Azure Stack HCI. And Azure Stack Edge is a new product that we've not talked about previously. We actually have one right here. It's a 1U compute server. It's a cloud-managed appliance. So the way that this works is you actually order one directly from the Azure portal. So you go to portal.azure.com and you buy one of these and it ships to your location from Microsoft. It's Microsoft's first-party hardware. And then you pay a flat monthly fee, and when you don't want it anymore, you just send it back. So it's, you can think of it like a compute server as a service. There's no minimum commitment, there's no fixed upfront cost, there's no capital expenditure. You just get an Azure Stack Edge as long as you need one to run computing at the edge. It's not HA, it's not resilient, it's a single, you can think of it as a compute server. So that's the family that we've announced this week here at Ignite.
Okay, thank you so far, Cosmos. I think one very important thing is when we compare these products, most of our persons that watch us know that Azure Stack and now Azure Stack Hub, there we use a portal to manage it. So we don't access the Windows Server and we don't access the infrastructure on it, we use the portal. In Azure Stack HCI, we have the situation that we can use the, let's say, traditional graphical user interface, or we can run it as a server core and manage it via Windows Admin Center. How is the situation at the Azure Stack Edge?
So it's a really good question, right? So all three of these products exist and will continue to exist for the long term because of the differences that in terms of what customers tell us they need. So actually, all three of them have a distinct minimum size, distinct starting price. They have totally different business models, and to your point, they have different management experiences, right? So when you're using Azure Stack Hub, you have a local instance of the Azure portal. There's two sides to it. There's the tenant portal and the administrator portal for you as the operator of an Azure Stack Hub. When you're using Azure Stack Edge, you're actually managing it from the public Azure portal. So there's a whole set of screens which you'll see, and you can actually get to them just from portal.azure.com. from the public internet, and that's how you manage the edge device. But to your point, with Azure Stack HCI, you have full access to all the familiar management tools that you expect. So things like Windows Admin Center, System Center, Virtual Machine Manager, or even automating things in PowerShell, all of that is available with Stack HCI.
Okay, yeah, great. In Azure Stack HCI, what's not absolutely clear to many customers is that the technology we use there is Windows Server, it's Hyper-V for virtualization, and Storage Spaces Direct. I often get to the question, is now the new name for Storage Spaces Direct Azure Stack HCI, or how is the correlation between it? Maybe you can say a few words about this.
Yeah, for sure. So there's a set of end product names, right? There's product brands like Azure Stack, and then there's a set of core technologies that we make at Microsoft. And these core technologies, their name really doesn't change, right? And so when we launched Microsoft Azure about 10 years ago, did we rename Hyper-V? No, right? Now, is Hyper-V the hypervisor that Azure runs on? Of course, right? It's Microsoft's first-party hypervisor that we use for everything. And so inside of Azure Public Cloud, inside of Azure Stack Hub, inside of Azure Stack HCI, you have Hyper-V, but and its name doesn't change even though they have different brands. Storage Spaces, I would say, is the same thing. We actually use Storage Spaces in Public Cloud Azure, and we use it in Azure Stack Hub, and we use it in Azure Stack HCI. In fact, I don't think this is widely known, but we actually use Storage Spaces inside of Azure Stack Edge at the physical disk level. So you'll see this thing comes with at least 4 SSDs, and we are doing Storage Spaces, specifically a single disk parity between the drives. So it's the same set of core technologies, whether you're talking about our public cloud at hyperscale or any of our intelligent edge infrastructure, it's the same pieces. It's Hyper-V, it's Storage Spaces, and their name really doesn't change, even as the way that we package them up and deliver them as products, that does change over time.
Yeah, great. So, and to clarify it again, so Azure Stack HCI is more or less the certified hardware for Storage Spaces Direct. This is how we can say it. And I think this is fair enough to switch for a short time to German to wrap it up. So der Azure Stack Hub, das ist der neue Name für den Azure Stack. Viele kennen ihn vom Namen her. Azure Stack Edge war die Verlängerung des Azure Rechenzentrums ins lokale Rechenzentrum hinein. Also eine sehr spannende und absolut neue Technologie. Und Azure Stack HCI nutzt die Technologien von Windows Server, Storage Spaces Direct auf einer zertifizierten Hardware. Und das ist ja unsere große Empfehlung, zertifizierte Hardware zu nutzen. Und da wechsle ich jetzt nochmal zurück auf Englisch. So, Cosmos, I mentioned that it's our recommendation to use certified hardware, certified Azure Stack HCI hardware, to build Storage Spaces Direct solutions. So this is important also to know that we configure Storage Spaces Direct on our own. So we choose the piece of hardware, we install the operating system and configure Storage Spaces Direct. But there were some news at Ignite here in Orlando about the configuration, because in the past we had Windows Admin Center to manage a configured Storage Spaces Direct configuration, to have a view on the performance data, the IOPS, configure the virtual machines. But we have seen some really cool new things. Maybe you can tell our customers a few words about this.
Yeah, absolutely. So the two things you touched on there. The first one is the validated hardware, and I do think that that's very important, right? When you buy an Azure Stack Edge, there really is just one. It's here it is, right? We have one directly here. Azure Stack Hub is an integrated system. There's 7 or 8 different versions, but it's still a fairly finite set of choices. With Azure Stack HCI, we have a third-party ecosystem with over 150 solutions from over 20 different partners. So there's an immense amount of variety in the catalog, and frankly, at this point, as we get more and more solutions, you have almost infinite choice and flexibility. So there's really not any good reasons to buy something outside of the catalog anymore, given that the partners, when they validate the solutions in the catalog, they do a lot of the work that you would have to do anyway. They determine exactly the correct versions of the drivers and firmware and the componentry that goes into the solution, and it saves you a lot of time. So absolutely, I recommend deploying Storage Spaces Direct first and foremost using the solutions from the catalog. And it's not some kind of a dark magic. It's not hard to find. You can go to Microsoft.com/HCI and you can browse them directly there. It just looks like a store. So that was the first thing. The second thing then is, once you actually receive that hardware, how do you set it up? And as you said, we used to not have really a good solution there. So customers would have to jump around between different tools, using PowerShell, using maybe Failover Cluster Manager to actually validate and create the cluster. And it was a little bit clunky. It was difficult to do. So this year at Ignite, we were really excited to announce on Monday that Windows Admin Center is being extended to not only manage an existing cluster, but actually be able to deploy Azure Stack HCI as well. So we have a multi-stage workflow with a set of screens that guides you through every step of the process, installing roles and features on the servers, restarting, configuring the physical network adapters, setting the IPs, setting the VLANs, getting everything configured. We'll check connectivity, and then we can deploy the cluster and enable Storage Spaces Direct all using using this nice workflow in Windows Admin Center. It's a work in progress, so what we showed this week at Ignite is a preview. There will be a lot more that we'll have to say over the coming weeks and months as we continue to develop this, but our goal is to make Storage Spaces Direct and the entire Azure Stack HCI stack very easy to deploy, even for someone who is a relative newcomer to our set of products, because it's been too hard up until this point. So I'm really, really thrilled that we're doing this now.
Yeah, great. I've seen the wizard in the session. I attended the session about configuring Azure Stack HCI via Windows Admin Center. It looked really great. So die Empfehlung für unsere Partner im Windows Business Solution Club, kommt zu unseren Veranstaltungen. Wir haben eine Ignite Tour, wo wir viele, viele dieser Dinge vorstellen. aka.ms/wbsc-events ist unsere Webseite und ich hoffe, unsere Ausführungen haben dazu geführt, dass ihr jetzt diese Themen Azure Stack Edge, Azure Stack HCI und Azure Stack Hub ein bisschen besser auseinanderhalten könnt. Eine letzte Frage ist aus meiner Sicht offen, so one last question, Cosmos. For sure I know the answer, but it's the most asked question about Azure Stack HCI and Azure Stack in the past and now for sure Azure Stack Hub. Can we migrate from Azure Stack HCI to Azure Stack Hub? Is there a migration path about it?
It's a good question. We don't see these as being products that customers will need to transform from one into the other. They really do address distinct categories, and we think a lot of customers are going to have a combination of these Azure Stack products in their environment. For example, you sort of get the hint from the naming that Azure Stack Hub and Azure Stack Edge, we think that you may well have a hub managing a number of edges, right? And you can sort of see that in the naming. At this time, we don't have anything to share about how to transform one of them to the other, because honestly, it's not really something that we think makes a lot of sense because they do address such different use cases.
Yeah, great, thank you for this. And this is a thing I have a similar meaning about this, because usually we will have different scenarios, as we mentioned, in Azure Stack HCI, typically virtual machine workload, and in Azure Stack Hub, more the Azure approach. So thank you very much, Cosmos, for your time. Thank you very much for the perfect explanation, and looking forward to see you. Ich freue mich schon, jemanden von euch oder alle von euch dann auf unseren Events zu sehen. Vielen Dank. Bis dahin. Tschüss.